Sup guys, this is Arsaferi and welcome to my channel. Basically, I'm doing some unboxing and reviews of airsoft guns or any airsoft related, and I have some ideas that I like to share to you on how to customize, modify and upgrade your airsoft guns to improve their performance. And I'm not an expert, I'm just an ordinary guy who learned things in the hard way. So if you want to know more on ideas that I want to share to you, you should subscribe to my channel and click the bell button so you will be updated for upcoming videos. Okay, and this is my modified KJ Works MK1 or Mark 1. Okay, and I have the unboxing video for this pistol. So if you haven't seen the video, I'm going to put the link in the description below, so you're free to check it out. Okay, so today I'm going to show you the modification that I've done in this pistol, externally and internally, so maybe you can get some idea. Okay, so but first we're going to shoot this pistol to the chrono. Okay, so I'm using map gas. Okay, and 0.2 gram BBs. Okay, .650, 6.38, 6.36. Okay, that's it. Okay, so as you can see, it shoots about 630, something like that, 635 FPS. Okay. Okay. So externally, this is how it looks. Okay. 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 So let's remove the red dot. So if you don't have the red dot, you can use your iron sight. Okay, see? Okay. Then let's take this one out. Okay. So first the pistol grip. Okay. So this pistol grip is made of wood. Okay, so I made it myself, and that's the first time I done it. Okay, so it's very far from perfect, but it's not an issue at all. Okay, I think it's not bad. Okay, and this grip is a right-handed grip. See? Okay. 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 And next. Okay. So the lower frame. Okay. So what I did is I take off the trigger guard. Okay, then put a new one. So this trigger guard is made of PVC plastic. Okay, Basically, it's a PVC pipe that I just flatten it to make it a trigger guard. Okay, and I use epoxy to glue it. Okay, so the original trigger guard is like this. Okay, then I just replace it with this one. Okay. Okay. The next is the firing pin. Okay. The original firing pin is kind of short. That's why I take it out and I put the new one. So what I did is I drill the hammer all the way, then I insert the screw. So the screw is the new firing pin. Okay, so it's more longer than the original one. Okay, see? Okay. So for the lower frame, that's the only thing that I modified. So that's it. Okay. For the upper, okay, first the front side. Okay, the front side is the aftermarket side for APS CAM870 airsoft shotgun. Okay, this is a fiber optic sight. The fiber optic is about 2 millimeter, okay, and it's really long. That's why it's really bright. So, and it sits perfectly and very nice on this pistol, on this barrel. Okay, see. Okay, and the barrel is carbon fiber tube. Okay, it's 25 millimeter diameter. It's just the same the diameter of the upper part of the pistol, so it's really matching up, so it's very nice. Okay, then the rail, the upper rail and the lower rail. Okay, I don't know where it came from because it's been too long. I have this long time ago, so I just take out this two from the box of my spare parts. So, and I use it for this build. Anyway, if you're looking for a rail, there's a lot available on online shop, so you just check it out. Okay, so then get one. Okay, and by the way, this one is I order it also on online, the outer barrel. Okay, I order it the matte finish, but I received glossy one. Okay, and instead of sending this one back to the seller, what I did is I sand it down with the 1000 grit sandpaper. Okay, so now this is how it looks. Okay, so it's not bad. Okay, and next is the fake bolt. Okay, so I put a sheet of plastic on both sides. Okay, just to lessen the movement of this hammer, because the hammer is moving side by side. Okay, so to lessen that, I put the plastic on the sides. So now actually it's hardly moving side by side, but it's free moving back and forth, so it's okay, and it really helps for the stability of the hammer, so that's good. Okay, then next is the rear side. The rear side is the stock one, so I didn't change anything on the rear side, and it's not that bad. Okay, so, and by the way, the upper rail, Okay. I glue it using the epoxy. So this is permanent on the upper part of the piston. Okay. So this is permanent band, and on the outer barrel, I just use screw. So anytime I want to remove or change the outer barrel, I can do so because it's just a matter of screw. Okay. So if I want to put a longer inner outer barrel, so to make it a sniper or something, I can. It's very easy. Okay. And also the rail from the lower rail is removable, so I can remove it easily. It's only a matter of a screw, okay. And next is the inner barrel half assembly, okay. So this one, okay. So this is a Maple Leaf BSR inner barrel. It's 300 millimeter 601 tight bore barrel. Okay, so what I did is I cut the end part of the inner barrel, the part where you put the half-up rubber. Okay, and after I cut it, I file this one in a cone shape. Okay, so it will fit perfectly to the magazine. Okay, because every time you pull the trigger, the inner barrel is moving back toward to the magazine. Okay, then I custom made a half up unit. Okay, this one. So this one I just made it myself. Okay, this half up unit is from the half up unit of an AEG, because I have a broken one, so I use that one to make this half up unit for this pistol. Okay, so still the same, the adjust, it's a TDC type. Okay, so this is the half up adjustment screw using the Allen key. Okay, so still it's a TDC type, so it's very easy, very simple. Okay, it's not really complicated. Okay, very nice. And then this one, so this is the rubber from a AEG half up rubber. Okay, so I just cut it down. Okay, so I cut a window in this part of the inner barrel. Okay, then I patch it with a rubber. Okay, so this is actually a R-hub system. Okay, then I put the masking tape just to hold it down in place. Okay, so this is a R-hub. Okay, and this part is from the original part of this pistol, so I just install it here so I can this one will, so it be this assembly will work on this pistol. Okay, so I just transfer this one here. It's from the original part. Okay, so I did this mod because I want to improve the air seal of this pistol. Okay, I'm not saying that the air seal of the stock one is bad, but I don't know, it's something that I have to do, or I need to do, I don't know. Okay, because the stock one is this one. Okay, so first the inner barrel is going to connect to half up unit, then the half up unit is the one who going to connect in the magazine. Okay, so maybe some air can pass through in this gap, so I'm not sure, or maybe not. Okay, so that's why I came up with this modification. Okay, so this one is only one piece inner barrel. Then the inner barrel is goes directly inside the magazine, so there's no way that the air can come out. Okay, because this is only one piece. Okay, so I think it's better, or I don't know. Anyway, if you want to use the original system, if you want to change for a longer inner barrel, you can do so. Okay, because this one is very easy to replicate in your aftermarket inner barrel, or if you want to make a longer one. Okay, so it's very easy, so you can do this one, or you can do my system. Okay, so it's up to you. Okay, so I'm just giving you some ideas, okay, and some alternative. It's up to you which one you prefer to use. Okay, and next is the magazine. Okay. Okay, so the magazine. First, I enlarge this opening of the magazine. Okay, this one. Okay, so I enlarge this opening. Then I polish it. Okay, one. Then next, I also enlarge this part. All the opening where the air passing through. Okay, so more air can pass through it. Okay, then next is the magazine bulb. Okay, so what I've done into the magazine bulb is I file this part. Okay, so I remove some materials on this part, so that when the firing pin hit the magazine bulb, and the magazine bulb will move far forward, so it going to create more opening, so more air can pass through. So that's it. Okay, that's why I file this one, so this one become thin and it can move far forward. So it has a bigger opening here. Okay, there. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so that's the all modification that I done in this pistol. Then, and honestly, I don't know which one of the modification that I've done is affecting the performance of this pistol, because when I done the modification, I done all at the same time. Okay, I didn't do one mod then I test the pistol. No, I just done everything at once, then after finishing it before I test the pistol. That's why I don't know which one affect the performance of this pistol. So maybe you get some idea, or if you want, you can experiment. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so I hope you get some ideas. Okay, from on the modification that I've done in this pistol, and I hope I help you in some way. Okay, so okay, so if you have any question or suggestion, okay, so just put it in the comment below, okay? So I'll try to answer all your questions, okay? And any suggestion, and I'm willing to try it, okay? If you have any suggestion, just put it in the comment below, okay? So please guys, help me grow my channel and support the channel by subscribing, hit the like button, and do share it, okay? Don't forget to click the bell button to notify you for the next video, okay? So this is Ersa Fairy, and keep safe. Thank you.